I got it.
There you go. Well, today is day three of the Grouse Camp Tour. We're here with Mark Fouts is helping us out. He's the Director of Member Relations and Outreach for the Rough Grouse Society and the American Woodcock Society. We are in northwestern Wisconsin, and Mark is mentoring these two young gentlemen. What's your names, guys?
My name's Tucker Johnson. And
what's your name?
My name's Wyatt Johnson.
Very nice. Mark's helping mentor these guys today, and I'm going to ask you guys a few questions. Tucker, what is your favorite thing about grouse and woodcock hunting?
Well, it's just fun to go hunting and be outdoors and fun watching the dogs and the challenge of, like, shooting just birds flying.
That's awesome. And Wyatt, same question for you.
Well, I love the outdoors and shoot sporting clays a lot, so this is a real thing. It's funner. And the meat tastes good.
That's awesome. And do your friends hunt too?
No, not all of them.
What do you think we need to do to get more young guys like you out hunting grouse and woodcock in the woods?
Probably bring them out in the woods and mentor them and stuff.
Okay. Do you guys have hunters that kind of help you, show you about bird dogs, show you about shotguns, and kind of show you how to do the hunt in the grouse woods?
Yeah, when we took hunter safety, they showed us some of that stuff, but my dad and Mark and some people, other people sometimes help us with that.
And does that help you? Does that kind of get you going, get you excited about grouse hunting and make you want to do it again?
Yeah.
All right. Well, thanks for being with us today, guys.
Thank you.
Good luck and shoot
Thank
straight.
You.
All right, this one. Wyatt! Got a point. Careful. Whoop.
Careful.
Awesome.
Whoop, whoop. Over here. Over here. Careful. 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 Here. Oh, good girl. Fetch it up. Come.
Leave it.
There. Come. Jordy. Come.
Good job, guys.
You ever look at it, Wyatt?
Hey, Mark, can we do a quick interview with you real quick?
Sure can.
Just a one question.
Here, Jordy.
Can you want the boys in there, too?
All right. All right. All right, my name is Mark Fouts, and I work for the Rough Grouse Society. Today, we have Wyatt Johnson with me today and his twin brother, Tucker Johnson, with us today. They're 12 years old. We're taking them out for a grouse and woodcock hunt today. And the reason why they're able to be out of school, they got straight A's in their classroom. So to me, I think it's very important for kids to get out, and especially mentors, to take young kids out to give them the experience, to let them enjoy the woods, enjoy the dogs, and the companionship of a mentor and a future, their hunting buddies as they grow to be older young men.
Who shot that bird?
Who was the shooter? Who got that bird?
I did.
You got that bird? Tucker Johnson got that bird. A nice, beautiful female woodcock. And we had a dog, a young puppy, well, she's 16 months old, Jordy, English pointer. And she did a nice job of pointing and retrieving. And this is what it's all about. Enjoying being safe. As you can tell, they're very safe hunters. Their guns are unloaded right now. Their action is open. There's no shells in the gun. And we're regrouping. We're getting the dog ready to go for the, try and find another bird for us today.
Good job, guys.
All right. Very safe. Good job. But you saw it running?
No, it's over there.
Right on the edge of the sand and on the edge.
No,
of
but
the
did you see that woodcock running in front of her?
He saw it moving.
That's oh, you crazy. Saw it moving.
That's awesome.
Great job.
Waiting on a little bird.
But here, there was two birds in that area.
Yep.
And what's the rule of thumb is never, you know, always think there's another bird.
Yep.
Just as the dog
Bet
stands.
The dog stays on point.
Hill.
Might be able to work that one again, Mickey.
Yeah, he didn't go across the slough here.
Okay, come on down this way, Tucker.
Okay.
Careful now. There we go. Careful, careful. Well, which way did you think it went? Okay. Come on out. Careful. Jordy! Bird is here. Careful now. Careful, careful. Careful. Careful.
There it is. Here's-
No bird, no bird, no bird, no bird.
Good shot. You didn't go very far either.
I'm my bird.
Whoa, whoa.
Eyes up, guys. Don't look at the dog. Don't look at the ground. Eyes up. That's where the bird's going to be.
Whoa, careful. Keep going, boy.
Keep going, Wyatt. Forward, forward.
Careful, careful. Careful. Whoa.
Hit it.
Careful,
easy,
easy.
Easy.
Boys, walk that way a little bit. Forward.
Careful.
You're fine.
There he is. No bird. No
and,
bird.
And then we'll go down by like that red tree, and there's just a little strip here that a lot of times holds birds.
Okay,
do
gang.
It.
You ready? Come on, boys.
Let's get some.
Jordy.
All right, guys, you can go ahead and load up, and each one of you get on each side of Mark.
See the
cats
on. Yep.
There we go. Come on!
Yeah, I can't see it, but I'm not tall. Maybe if I got up on your shoulders.
What's that, Greg? What'd you say?
On your left.
Quiet, go to your right. Right to your right. Stay to your right. Stay to your right. Okay.
Get your gun ready. 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 Keep going. That's fine. Careful, careful. 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 Man, oh man, is there some bird throw.
So this is that trail, Mark.
Woodcock right behind us, take it!
Oh.
Look to your right, see the opening? See that opening to the right? She's looking back over her left. Tucker, stay to, your, stay to her left. Bring back your gun up. Right there. There it is. Keep moving, keep moving. Woodcock up! Good bird!
Got it.
Dead bird! Good guys, job, stay right boy. There. Stay right there.
Good job.
Come on over here, Buckwheat.
Another nice bird.
Very nice bird. Beautiful. It's a beautiful bird. Congratulations.
Thanks.
You both, come on up here. Good job.
All right. So,
tell us the story, guys.
Tell us what happened here.
I don't know what happened.
You don't know what happened? Was the dog on point?
Yeah.
The dog was on point, and where were you?
To the right.
To the right of the dog, and where were you, Tucker?
To the left.
And so what happens? When I went in and got the bird up, what'd you guys do?
Oh, the one that went that way, I didn't have a shot at it, but the one that went this way, the crossing shot.
You had a crossing shot at it?
Yeah.
Okay. Is that the same thing for you? That bird behind us, we didn't shoot because it was over the top of all of us?
Yeah.
So we didn't shoot, and then she was still pointing this bird, wasn't she?
Mm-hmm.
There was two birds in the area, so we were safe. And look at what happened when we're safe. We got a beautiful shot on a beautiful bird. Great job, boys. Great job.
Good job, guys.
Excellent.
Can I take a picture of you real quick? Ben, close together. There you go. Maybe get the dog in there, too.
Okay. Come here, babe.
Yeah, give the boys a bird.
There you go.
There's a bird. There's a bird.
Owned by the bird.
Yeah, there you go. Wait.
Three.
Good job, guys. One, two, three. One more. One, two, three. Way to go.
Cool. That's a good job. All right.
Go ahead.
My name is Mark Fouts. I work for the Rough Grouse Society. I'm the Director of Membership Relations and Outreach Program. I've been with the Rough Grouse Society for over 17 years. I've been a RGS chapter member of Duluth Superior for almost 24 years. So today I'm hunting with Wyatt Johnson and Tucker Johnson. They're the kids of our banquet chairman, our local chairman in the area.
And what were we up to today?
Today we were out doing a mentor of woodcock hunt. We were trying to do a grouse hunt, but it ended up being only woodcock. And there was some fantastic dog work, plenty of birds, and the boys did some nice shooting today.
And what's your main practice when you're taking youth out? Do you try to teach them lessons?
Well, the main thing is we go through the mentor program that we have, and it's all about hunter safety. You teach them about that before you even go in the woods. It's tough teaching what to do, where to be with your gun before you go in the woods. You want to do that all up front. And then you talk about dog handling, where the dogs are and how to handle the dogs. And then you talk about habitat. That's through the mentor program. These boys have been exposed to hunting the last few years, and so they have some idea of what we're trying to accomplish.
When did the Mentor Hunter program start, and what are some of the specifics on how it works?
Oh, it started this last year. We just rolled it out here in June, and we officially kicked it off in October. We're a little bit behind, but it'll be fully rolled out in 2016. And again, it talks about hunter safety, habitat, what to look for. Also talks about dog handling skills, and then there'll be a mentor program for adults to take out youth, women, anybody that wants to be part of the mentor program.
And how does the mentor program work? Who puts it on?
Chapters will put it on. Each chapter is able, we'll have a youth coordinator at each chapter level, and then we'll put on the, at a local level with a local gun club, a dog training club, NAVDA, Perina's going to be a big sponsor, Sport Dog helps us out. So it's going to be a big national program that we'll roll out in 2016.
And I know you are mentoring young hunters and new hunters is something that's very important to you. Why do you think it's essential that the Rough Grouse Society is putting this program on?
Well, I think it's always important to give back, you know, pay something forward, you know, whether you belong to a conservation group, belong to a school association, your church, but you have to give something back. And to me, I think it's important to give back for the mentoring program because we're losing some individuals to hunting, and I think there are a lot of youth days, but I think physically you have to take them out hunting to show them all the experiences that you can accomplish out here, the camaraderie with your friends, and all the ethics that come along with a great sporting tradition that we have.
What are some of the cool things that happen when young hunters like Tucker and Wyatt kind of figure it out?
Well, one of the great things is when they figure it all out, but when they actually shoot their first bird in the air. You know, I know everybody's, you know, shot in birds different ways, but when they actually shoot their first flight bird, to me, there's nothing more exciting, especially with a youngster, because it's a big accomplishment. It's not the easiest thing to do. I always say rough grouse hunting and woodcock hunting, I think, are the toughest of all the bird hunting because, again, you're in the woods, you're picking your feet up here, you're picking your feet there. A lot of times you're carrying your gun at a safe position with one hand because you're using your left hand, your left arm to block the tree. So I think that's the
best accomplishment that you can have for a youth.
And when you take new hunters out, what do you focus on as far as safety?
Safety is always the muzzle forward, you know, up, because people fall in the woods, and we've all fallen for adults. So if you can teach them safety at the safe position, the ready position up, I think that's important, and that's what you always look for. So as a mentor, you know, as you saw today, sometimes I was to the side of the Tucker or Wyatt, and I would just take their muzzle and just move it a little bit, just a reminder for them that more forward, more up.
Some of the most fun moments of today's hunt.
Well, to me, the most fun moments is watching the boys position themselves in the proper position when the dog goes on point, knowing where to be, where the hole is at, watching their gun safety, watching them come around, getting ready to shoot. You know, to me, that shows they've been, you know, taught by a father who's been mentoring them since they've been young. And that's what the mentoring program is you have to mentor, you have to teach them out in the woods how to do this. We'll have the program at the chapter level, but when it all comes together, we saw what comes together, and we'll see that on film. What do you think, Wyatt? You think, what was your best part today?
When the birds got up and we were shooting at them, it was a challenge to see if we were going to hit them or not.
Did you feel like when you how many birds do you think you shot at today?
Three, four, or five.
I like you're a good woodcock hunter because you've already multiplied the numbers of birds. I like it. How about you, Tucker? What was the best part for you today?
Following the dog around the woods, and just like if you foot flush a bird, then you have to get ready and you don't know it's going to come up.
When we were foot flushing a bird and it wasn't over a dog point, what was the rule of thumb today? What did I ask you to do or not to do?
If the dog bumped it, you didn't want us to shoot it because it would be a learning point for the dog. But if we foot flush it, we could shoot it if it was high, but if it was low, then we couldn't shoot it.
And what does that tell us? That, you know, what we're trying to do is have a quality hunt and an enjoyable hunt. And I always say this way, if with woodcock, you only have three birds to shoot. You only got three birds to shoot. So why not make those three birds a great story? Make those three birds memorable. You know, if you just want to foot flush a bird, anybody can do that. But why not make each bird a story? And I think that's what this program's all about. So why not? We're trying to create memories. And that's what I'm saying with the dog, the bumps, the foot flushes, let those go. And let's get the dogs working. So that's a story that, you know, they're going to remember every shot they had today, all the good ones and through the dog work. That's what we're about.
And if members or chapters or even the public, if anyone is interested in getting involved with this new mentor hunter program, what's the best way for
them? If they're not involved at the chapter level, I was going to say they can contact their banquet chairman or the bouch in the area, or they can go to our website and look up my name and get in contact with me, and then I'll put them in contact with the chapter so we can get them on the rolls if they want to be a youth coordinator in their area. And I look forward to any help, any name.